Our software supports both physical and digital inventory. Let's take a look at how to add a new physical product to your account, as well as how to customize features such as shipping and taxes. Start by selecting Add Product from the Products drop-down menu. Here, you can quickly create a new product with just the basic details such as the product name, SKU, and price. After you fill these initial details in, the product will be saved and you can continue to modify additional details such as shipping, taxes, and categories. First, enter a product name. This name will be displayed when a customer has added this product to their shopping cart. Next, if you keep track of your products with a unique product code or SKU number, enter that number here. Otherwise, leave it blank. Next, enter the price for your product. Keep in mind, if you would like to place this item on sale, simply enter a discounted sale price below and check On Sale. This will display the discounted price to the customer on the shopping cart. If a product sale has ended, you can turn this feature off and the sale price will be hidden. If you are setting up a new product and don't want to allow customers to purchase it just yet, you can deselect Active. This way, if a customer finds a link to purchase this product on your website, the shopping cart will explain that it is not available for purchase at that time. Keep in mind, all of these settings can be modified again at a later time. Finally, you can assign your product to one or multiple categories here. If you don't see any listed, you'll need to set up your categories. Just click on Manage Categories from the Products drop-down menu. This isn't a required step, and you can always add this product to a category at a later time. When you're finished, press the Continue button. Now, you can modify additional inventory options from the Edit Products screen. This is the same screen shown when you edit an existing product in your account. If you need to learn more about a particular feature when adding or editing a product that we don't cover in this tutorial, search or browse for more tutorials in the Products category. Now that your new product has been saved, you can see a system-generated product ID. This number is used to identify this product throughout the application. As well, we can see the initial product details that we specified on the previous screen. Below that, expand the shipping section simply by clicking on the header. You may have set up your global shipping options from the Setup Shipping feature located under the Products drop-down menu, but here you can determine shipping options for this particular product. First, if you choose to provide a shipping dollar amount or weight for shipping calculation, you'll need to activate shipping for this product by checking this option. Next, enter the shipping dollar amount that should be added to the customer's order when purchasing this product. Then, if you are using weight-based shipping for your account, you will need to specify a weight in pounds for this item. Next, under the Taxes header, you can select whether or not you would like to charge state or country tax for this product. Taxes values are specified from the Setup Taxes feature found under the Products drop-down menu. This simply gives you the option to turn taxes on or off for this product. For more information on the type and amount of sales tax you should be charging, you may want to check with your local tax advisor. Under the Product Links header, you'll see Shopping Cart links or Add to Cart buttons that you can copy and paste into your website or blog. We'll cover these links and buttons in a separate tutorial in this series. For now, let's continue to set up this product before adding product links to our website. Under the Optional Values header, you'll see a number of additional features that you can set up for this product. First, under the Upsell header, you can decide how this product should appear in your shopping cart. The shopping cart can display up to 3 featured products, as well as 3 related products, to your customers, depending on the contents of their cart. Brief information about featured and related products will appear below the shopping cart, where customers can quickly add them to their order. These are considered product upsells or special offers. To specify this as a feature product, simply check this option. Keep in mind, featured products will be displayed for all purchases on the shopping cart. Next, to show related or suggested products to customers on the shopping cart, click Manage Related Products. Here, you can select up to 3 products that will be shown as related products below the shopping cart. If you have a large inventory, you may need to perform a search to locate your product. Otherwise, simply check to select your related products below. When you're finished, press the Save and Close button above. This will refresh and save the previous page so that you can continue to edit this product. Now, enter a short and long product description. The short description will be used when displaying your product on the shopping cart, while the longer description will be used when a customer views additional information about a featured or related product. The product image is used when displaying a featured or related product on your shopping cart. Press the Select button to browse the media library for your product image. If you haven't uploaded this product image already, simply upload it to the media library from your hard drive, select it, and press the Insert button. Our software will save a full-size and thumbnail version of the image. Next, if you would like to track the inventory level for this product, you can specify a current inventory count as well as a reorder level number. Every time this product is purchased, the inventory count will go down. If you would like to be informed by the software when the inventory level reaches a certain number, enter that number in the reorder level field. If you have chosen to track inventory for this product, when the inventory level reaches zero, customers will be informed on the shopping cart that this item is no longer in stock. If you would like to allow customers to continue their purchase in this case, check the Allow Back Order feature. Otherwise, customers will not be able to complete their order. Keep in mind, inventory tracking is completely optional. Next, under the Navigation heading, you can specify where you would like to redirect your customers after they have purchased this product specifically. If you would like to specify a global value for these options instead of on a product-by-product basis, you can do so from the Orders screen under the Setup drop-down menu. If you leave these fields empty, these global settings will be used instead. The Destination URL is where your customers are taken when they are on your shopping cart page and press the Continue Shopping button. The Thank You URL is where your customers are taken after they have successfully completed their order. And if you would like to redirect a customer to a specific web page if they have chosen to clear their cart completely, you can enter a web address in the Clear Cart URL field. If you leave this field blank, your customer will simply see an Empty Cart message on their shopping cart. Next, under the Product Layout heading, you can add custom HTML or plain text content that will appear above or below the shopping cart when this product has been added to your customer's order. This is a great way to display additional details or instructions specific to this product. Finally, if you set up any third-party services from the Third-Party Integrations option under the Setup drop-down menu, you can activate them on a product-by-product basis under this header below. When you are finished setting up all of the details for this new product, press the Save Changes button. To make changes to this product at a later time, simply search or browse your inventory from the Manage Products screen and click on this product's name.